Good morning, children. How are you all? Fine? Good. My name is Gayatri, English teacher of Dr. Besant School. Today, we are going to have a second standard English subject. So, are you all ready with your books, children? I think I told you yesterday to be ready with your companion books. We are going to do our exercise 2A in companion book, right? So, please open your companion books, children. So, are you ready, children? Yes? See, this is your companion book. Open this page number 13. Companion. Page 13, children, 2A. Okay. Observe people around you. We have many relations around us, right? Mother, father, grandmother, grandfather, uncle, aunt, friends, sisters, brothers, cousins, neighbors. Different people are there around us. Daily, from morning to night, we meet many of them. Yes or no, children? So identify two people who you think do not give up easily. Means you have to find out, give up in the sense you will do anything for them. And if vaallu kavali anukunte edaina vadilestaru, but you won't love to leave them. You love them so much. So out of all these people, whosoever they may be your father or mother or grandparent or grandfather or grandmother or uncle or aunt or cousins or sisters or brothers, anyone, I have to identify two people. For them, you can't give up them for any reason. You don't want to leave them for any reason. Think of that. Think of those two people. This can be a parent, teacher, friend, house help, or anyone. So now you have to find out those two persons. Give a brief description of each person in the given space. Okay. First person. See, this what I am giving you on the board today is about myself. Not that you have to write the same. You can think of two people whom you don't want to give up. Okay. Suppose first I don't want to give up for my mother and father. Mother or father, anyone. Any of them, I'll not give them up for any reason. I don't want to leave them. Description. Give up my love on my mother and father for any reason. Okay? So I'll not give their love. Their love and affection is more important than anything else which they give me on this world. Okay? So I don't want to give their love. I don't want to give up their love for any reason. I love them so much. And you can also write, they love me a lot than any other person in this world. For that only, I don't want to give up them for any reason. You can write like that also. And you can also write, from my childhood to this, they have just came out with me in such a way that Whatever I used to ask them, they used to give me. Whatever I want, they used to know beforehand and they used to arrange me. And they never said no to my feelings. They never said no to my wishes. Always they tried to give me the best. For that, I don't want to give them up for any reason. In that way also, you can write children. So just all these are some ideas for you. You can copy this in your rough book and write your own views whom you don't want to give up in the textbook. Right, children? Note them, give finger gap and note properly so that you'll not get any doubts by seeing your handwriting only. You can pause the video and write, children. Completed. Completed, children. Shall I rub the board and give about second person? Person 2 now. My friend. Description. I will never give up my relationship. With my friend, for any reason. See, with my friend, I don't want to lose her relationship. She loves me so much. I too love her so much. I can share all my happiness and sadness with her. She always gives me good ideas when I feel sad, if I have a problem. So in such cases, I don't want to leave her for any reason. Right, children? So you can also explain your views, how your relationship bonds between you and your friend. If not friend, you can write about your cousin or brother or sister if you have the same relationship. Like that, you can go on explaining, children. If not, you just copy whatever I'm giving you on the board. Right, children? Just copy it down. Copy, children. Give finger gap properly and write and copy so that when you read or when you copy the same, you think of your ideas to just keep it as a reference. It'll be easy for you to read what you wrote. Right, children? Completed. Pause the video, children, if the time which I'm giving you is not sufficient. Just pause the video. Okay, completed, children. Fine. Now down to that, you see. Choose one person from the two. About now, you wrote about two persons. Suppose I wrote about my mother and father, and I wrote for my mother or father, and the second I wrote for my friend. So ask them to narrate a situation in their life where they did not give up. So you ask them anything happened. Ante edaina vachinda dani kosam ani they left anything else like that for what they didn't give up. You just ask a story from them and give the title for their experience. Suppose I took a story from my mother. She told me that when she was 4 or 5 years old, one day her cousin sister, she was just playing a joke that she is taking her mother, my mother's mother, with her. Then my mother started crying. This cousin, she gave my mother many chocolates. I'll give you chocolates, I'll give you ice creams, many things, but I'll take your mother with me. But my mother, she did not give up for her mother. She loved her mother so much. She left all her favorite chocolates, ice creams, everything for her mother. Yes, that is the story she told me. So then after like that, you listen a story from the two persons whom you wrote in this book and give it a proper title. If I gave, by listening that story, I gave a title to my mother's story that baby's love. Baby's love. Small babies, they love their mother so much, right? They don't know, they don't want anything else except their mother. So I gave a title called Baby's Love. Like that, you think or you listen a story from the two persons whom you love the most. After listening that, you just give a title to that story like this, and you write in the last blank. See, in this, I left here empty blank. No, in this blank, you have to write. Okay, children. Right. Now, let me rub the board first. Right, children. So before ending the class, that's all for today, your textbook part. Before ending the class, I want to explain you some few grammar parts. Okay, which we are doing already, which we were doing in the earlier classes also, even in the before lesson also, we did some plural part, I think. So, apart from that, I want to teach you some nouns, pronouns, these parts of speech today. So tell me, children, how many parts of speech so far we have completed? You don't know what are parts of speech, right? Okay, whatever grammar part we have completed so far, nouns we have completed, pronouns in your first standard, children, verbs, adverbs, adjectives. Yes or no, children? We have completed nouns, pronouns, verbs, adverbs, adjectives. Till now we completed all these five grammar part. Yes or no? So now tell me, remember once, what are nouns, children? Tell me, what are nouns? Tell to your parents who is sitting with you. Listen, parent, whether they are telling the correct answer or not. What are nouns? Nouns are naming words. Yes or no, children? Nouns are naming words which tell us the names of persons, places, animals and things. Whatever you see around you, we call that thing or person or place, anything with a particular name. Yes or no? Those names are called nouns. Those names are called nouns. Suppose this is a chalk piece. Chalk piece is a noun. This is my hand. Hand is a noun. This is a Bluetooth. Bluetooth is a noun. This is a chunni. Chunni is a noun. This is my bangle. Bangle is a noun. Ears, noun. Eyes, noun. Nose, noun. Mouth, noun. All these names which we call with, all those names are nouns. Whatever you have, right now you have in your hands, mobiles, mobile is a noun. TV, TV is a noun. Fan, noun. Light, noun. Chair, noun. Table, noun. All these which you call the names with, those are nouns. Yes? Very good. So next is pronouns. Next part of speech I taught you is pronouns. So tell me children, what are pronouns? In the word itself, you have the word nouns. Means that is related with nouns. This pronoun is related with nouns. How they are related? Pronouns are the words which are used in place of noun. Pronouns are used in place of nouns. Suppose for all the time we can't repeat the name, no? For that generally we say for boys, he, for girls, she, for animals and things, it. If there are many people in one place, we generally say they. If I am also in that people, I'll say we, you. All these are pronouns. Instead, every time I say Kim is a boy, Kim is a boy, Kim is a boy, I can say he is a boy. He in the sense, I'll show it to him. He in the sense, Kim. Sita is a girl. She is a good girl. Sita is a girl. Sita lives in Ramnagar colony. Sita studies in Dr. Basin school. Sita studies in second standard. Instead of using Sita for many times, I can use in place of Sita. First I use, Sita is a girl. She lives in Ramnagar colony. She is a student of Dr. Basin school. She studies second standard. In place of Sita, I can use she. So she will be pronoun. For animals and things, generally we use it. If many people in one place, we generally use they. If in that people many, if I am also there, then we say we. We means we all. Nenu kuda andalo unnanu. We. If I want to tell you, who are you? You is a pronoun. So the words which are used in place of nouns, those are pronouns. Right, children? Next I taught you is verbs. So children, tell me, what are verbs? Verbs are action words. Yes or no? Verbs are action words. Action words means which shows the action done by the nouns. Which shows us the action done by the nouns. Means suppose Sita is playing. What Sita is doing? Playing. Hari is jumping. What Hari is doing? Jumping. Means the action done by Hari is jumping. The action done by Sita is playing. So those are verbs. Action words. Verbs are action words. Next, adverbs. So tell me children, what are adverbs? Adverbs are nothing but which tells us more about the verbs and nouns. How Sita is playing restlessly. How she is playing without taking rest. Continuously she is playing. Restlessly is a adverb. She is writing neatly. How she is writing neatly. Neatly will be an adverb. Will be an adverb. Okay. So, which describes the verb. How the verb action is done. Whether neatly or slowly or fastly or beautifully or ugly. Anything, whatever they may be. Fast, not fastly, fast. All those are adverbs only. Right, children? Which describes the verbs. Verbs are action words. And adverbs are the words which describes the verbs. Okay, and the last one is adjective. So tell me children, what are adjectives? Adjectives are describing words. Here also there is description, but here also there is description. So what is this? This describes the noun and this describes the verb, that's all. These two are, because verbs, these two are interlinked. This is related with noun. She is a tall girl. What kind of girl she is? Tall. Means she here, the noun, no? So the noun it is describing, whether the noun is tall or short or beautiful or ugly, all these are adverbs, adjectives. Adjectives are describing words which describe the noun. Understood, children? So once read along with me. Nouns are naming words. Nouns are naming words. Pronouns are the words which are used in place of nouns. Pronouns are the words which are used in place of nouns. Verbs are action words. Verbs are action words. Adverbs describe the verbs. Adverbs describe the verbs. Adverbs describe the verbs. Adjectives are describing words. Adjectives are describing words. Adjectives are describing words. They describe the noun. Right, children? And from tomorrow, we are going to do some activities, worksheets on adjectives only. Right, children? So be ready with your studio books, pencil eraser sharpener and water bottle for tomorrow's class. I'll meet you in the next class. Till then, take care and bye-bye.